Hello, Airbus Cockpit Coach here. You're joining me in the flight deck of the Fenix A320, and in this video we're going to look at the climb procedures. So we've just passed flight level 100, and at that stage, passing flight level 100, we'd start our 10,000 foot flow. So we'd cross-check that our landing lights are off. The seat belts would be now as required, so we want to check that there's no turbulence, we can't see any weather ahead which is likely to cause us an issue, and also our pitch is 7.5, so the angle for walking around in the cabin isn't just a bit too steep and will cause issues. We take a view on that. The aircraft has accelerated, we pitched down a little bit, it will further pitch down as we reach our cruise. I'm going to take the seat belts off now. Then we come and we adjust our EFIS system, electronic flight information system, and we generally range out. It's my company's standard operating procedure to select airports above flight level 100. You can set this up as per your discretion, and the first officer would also do the same over on their side. Next we'd come down and we would clear out our RADNAV page, so anything in here which we've pre-tuned before departure to help us, say, with an engine out procedure, we'd clear those out now. There's nothing in there today, but you'd just literally go clear and clear the entry. And then we go to the secondary flight plan, and we would copy the active flight plan into the secondary, so we're therefore overwriting the engine out procedure we put in earlier for our departure, as we no longer need that. Then we go to the flight plan page, and we select a fix from the left side. We go to fix info, and we can remove our engine out runway marker, so the 254 radial off runway 25 at Luton, and we simply select clear and clear that out. Then we come to the progress page. We want to make sure that our cruise is not above our recommended maximum, and ideally close to our optimum, although due to winds today, flight planning has given us a lower cruise altitude, but that's not going to be an issue today on here, so we're not busting through our recommended max, which could cause concern. We'd need to review the flight levels. We'd also want to fill in our two section here, so usually you can put your alternate aerodrome in, for example, or in this case I'm going to put our arrival aerodrome in Golf Papa Hotels, Edinburgh, and runway 24, and it gives us a bearing and distance for quick reference to the threshold of runway 24 at Edinburgh. During climb we want to keep an eye out for icing on the aircraft, so whenever the TAT temperature down here is below plus 10 degrees and we're in visible moisture, so clouds, we want to turn the engine anti-ice on up here. That's not the case today, so we don't need that. Many of the Airbus A320 aircraft out there now are now fitted with automatic ice detection, so that's when we would react if we had ice detection on the airframe, and turn on wing anti-ice. We can also visibly detect icing on the airframe, so we've got the icing probe just up here, and if we're flying at night we can illuminate that using the ice indicator and standby compass light. Oh, the standby compass does illuminate it light as well. You can see that's where that is. There's a little light inside that probe. It's not particularly bright. It's in the real world, it's also a struggle to see that. If you look over the glare shield at your wipers as well, that's another area where you'll see icing occur, and also around the edges of the glass. That's where we see it in the real world. So if you do visibly see ice, the wing anti-ice is a reactive feature we use, so we'd then turn on the wing anti-ice. That does have quite a big impact on engine performance, so be aware of that. And next we just need to make sure we're monitoring our ECAM, ensuring our cabin altitude is looking sensible. At cruising altitude you won't get a cabin altitude above 8,000 feet, so you just need to make sure that the cabin altitude is not running away in a particular direction, because obviously that's crucial. Keeping an eye on temperatures, making sure we're maintaining a decent temperature in the cabin. If you need to adjust, we've got our selectors here. And we're just looking out for any vibration on the engines, monitoring performance throughout the climb. So those are the climb checks in the Airbus A320. If you have any questions on that, please drop them in the comments. And don't forget to hit like and subscribe, and I'll catch you on the next one. Thanks for watching.